How to perform a purge on the HPLC system and connect SEC columns. Welcome to the control room of the swing beamline. The monitoring and control of the purge of the columns during the SEC-SACS experiments can be done via these two screens. The HPLC ChemStation screen on the left for a global view of the process, and the SEC-SACS setup screen on the right, where column parameters can be set to execute the purge. First, on the SEC-SACS setup screen, the following information about columns needs to be specified. Column name, the maximum pressure allowed for the column. If this value is reached, the system will stop automatically. The total volume of the column, the working elution flow rate, the elution volume, which will define the start of the buffer acquisition after injection, the elution volume, which will define the end of the buffer acquisition before the dead volume, the elution volume, which will define the start of the sample acquisition after aggregates have eluted. The sample acquisition will stop when the total volume of the column is eluted. And finally, an elution pre-equilibration time. An additional elution volume, during which the elution continues without recording SACS data. This is to ensure a stable baseline before the automatic injection of the next sample. The exposure and dead times for the detectors, usually 1 second in total. The HPLC setup allows the use of two columns in parallel. Parameters for the second column need to be registered too. One circuit is named circuit 1 and the other one is named circuit 2. Any additional information, such as UV wavelengths to be sampled and column's temperature, can also be added. When all parameters have been set, save the values and execute the workflow in order to save the parameters in a database. After ensuring that the X-ray shutter is closed, inside the experimental hutch, on the Agilent HPLC paddle, set the flow to zero on the two circuits. Use the arrows to shift from one circuit to another. Do not forget to press the return button to validate the values. Then place the plunger of the circuit 1 with a blue sticker into the buffer chosen for this circuit. If necessary, do the same for circuit 2, indicated with a yellow sticker. When this is done, the circuit purge has to be executed from the control room. On the SEC-SACS setup screen, the purge HPLC pump parameters need to be filled. If a circuit needs to be purged, the circuit to be purged parameter has to be B1, otherwise fill with a dash. In this example, the two circuits will be purged simultaneously, hence B1 was entered for the two circuits. Then you have to select the active circuit to rinse the injection loop with the buffer with which you want to perform the next injection. To execute the workflow, press the green triangle button. A pop-up window appears to remind you to check the column parameters. If everything is correct, press yes. At this moment, all the information about the columns which have to be purged are sent from the database to the HPLC software. You can follow the purge process on the HPLC ChemStation screen. When all the rectangles are blue, this means that the purge is running It takes around 6 minutes. When the purge is finished, every rectangle goes back to green, and the flow rate for each circuit is the one defined previously by execution of the SEXAC setup screen. The purge of the circuit with the buffer is done, so the columns can be physically connected in the experimental hutch. Set the flow to 0.1 milliliter per minute for the circuit. The circuit 1 is represented with the blue tubing, whereas the circuit 2 is represented with the beige tubing. Replace the tubing between the unions in the blue circuit by the column. To avoid air bubbles, screw up only to halfway the connector in the column inlet. Then screw completely the connector in the column outlet. Finally, screw completely the connector in the column inlet and place the column into the temperature controlled column holder. Then set the flow to the desired value. Repeat the same procedure for column 2 as required. Set back the flow to the desired volume. The procedure is now finished. You can prepare your samples for SACS data collection during the equilibration of the columns.